Hello, everybody. Welcome again to Price Links. My name is Phil Flynn. I am Senior Market Analyst at the Price Futures Group, as well as a Fox Business Network contributor. Everybody knows what everybody's thinking about this weekend. It's Pigskin Picks. That's right. Where are the hogs and the bellies going? That's right. Belly supplies at a 50-year low. The little piggies have been all over the place, but they seem to be going higher. Who knows why? Only this man here, Jack Scoville, Vice President at the Price Futures Group. Welcome back, Jack.
Happy to be here.
Good to have you back. You got a pigskin pick for me, baby, for this weekend, huh?
Well, I guess I'm hoping for the Atlanta Falcons to win because...
Oh, Falcons. Oh, the football game. I was talking about pork bellies here.
Oh, well, pork bellies.
50-year low for supplies. But does that really matter in the belly market anymore?
Well, of course it does. And we've seen the prices have reacted. We've seen belly prices go very high. Of course, we don't see them in the futures anymore. We only trade the hogs, not the bellies. But bacon prices did recover from some big lows here late last year. We saw a lot of featuring late last year to kind of drive that force.
Well, we did, but hasn't this market changed a little bit? When we talk about supplies, are they talking about a 50-year low supply in storage, which we don't store as much, or is it just overall fresh supply that we're short on?
No, it's mostly the stored supplies, and those were getting used by food service companies. And those will start to build again. A lot of the food service companies have started to pull back. So we'll see those supplies start to build again. But I haven't really noticed much of a change in the grocery store. So I think that the actual bacon supplies are fine, or at least the packers are able to hold the prices, and the wholesalers have been holding the prices.
But you got to feed these hogs. What do you feed your hogs? If you had hogs, Jack, would you be feeding them soybeans? Would you be feeding them corn? What do you feed your hogs?
Well, I think you mostly feed them slop, but mostly it would be a combination of corn and soybean meal.
Slop, that's what I had for dinner last night. Hey, wait a second. Slop for dinner. All right, so you'd be feeding slop and corn. But this time of year, what do you think about the – obviously, listen – corn supplies, beans, so everybody's focused on beans. They don't feed a lot of soybeans to pigs, do they?
No, a little bit of soybean meal, but mostly it's corn or whatever else they can shove in there.
Soybean supplies, okay, this is a big one. South American weather, I get 18 calls a day. What's the weather in South America? I go to Jack, what's the weather in South America? What is the weather in South America?
Well, we're entering kind of a key weekend here. There's supposed to be some nice rains up in the northern parts of Brazil, which could actually get into some of the dry coffee areas as well, which is a whole nother subject. But could slow the harvest of soybeans in Goiás, Mato Grosso, up into Tocantins and all these areas in the north.
How good is that crop, though?
If the crop is good. The Brazil crop's rated very high. A lot of people looking for somewhere between 103 and 105 million tons. And really, the ideas are going more towards the upper end of that range.
So if you're going to get a big crop, do these harvest delays really matter? Is it that critical? Or?
Well, it just offers maybe another shot for the U.S. to participate, because what it does is it keeps the prices at the ports a little bit higher than they might normally be if there's a lot of product to move.
Interesting. Okay, now let's go back. What other things are you worried about? The South America, the weather, its impact on the prices and corn, wheat, soybeans, you name
it. Well, we have to keep an eye on the Argentine weather, which had those flooding rains here about a week or so ago. Then the weather turned better. But now this weekend could feature some more heavy rains as well. So that's something to keep a very close eye on over the weekend. And could impact production. The other thing I'm keeping an eye on is the corn harvest, the corn production. Because basically the region, Brazil especially, ran out of corn last year, and they need to refill those pipelines. So as the corn starts to come off and refill those pipelines, we'll see how the prices act down there, because right now they're not competitive in the world market. It'll take quite an influx of corn to make those prices get competitive. And that might take till this summer.
Well, the other big country that buys a lot of our corn is Mexico, and it's going to be harder to get it through a wall that's going to be there over the next couple of years. Is Mexico going to stop buying U.S. corn, or do they have little choice but to be one of our biggest customers?
Well, it's not only corn, but soybeans and soybean meal and rice. They're the largest buyer of U.S. rice as well, and I think it's a problem for U.S. agriculture. I think the Trump administration is going to try and find ways to kind of stick it to Mexico, keep them buying our product, and in fact do a protectionist policy, but keep agriculture kind of out of it. And I think they're going to have a very, very hard time. I do think that there's an excellent possibility that we're going to see less overall demand for U.S. corn, wheat, soybeans, rice, and just because of these policies and because of some of the stances that we're taking around the world. And I am kind of worried about it for the U.S. agriculture.
There you go. He's a little bit worried about the wall. Who is your pick for the Super Bowl?
Atlanta. I just like to see somebody. I like New England. I've spent a lot of years going out there all the time, but I have a lot of friends and family out there. But we need some new blood in there. And let's get Atlanta's never won the Super Bowl. Let's let them have a chance.
All right. He's giving them a chance. And thanks, everybody, for Price Links. If you need some information about ags or softs, this is the guy to talk to, Jack Scoville. Just shoot him an email, jscoville@pricegroup.com. He'll be happy to answer your questions. And have a great game. Good night.